Hello everyone, this is Chetan Singhal. Welcome to my channel Stats Shine, where knowledge shines to make you shine. Before we get started, just a brief introduction about myself. I have done my graduation from Hindu College, Delhi University in Statistics, and I have completed my Master's from IIT Bombay in Applied Statistics and Informatics. So in my earlier videos, I have talked about the different courses that IIT offered Mathematical Statistics Examination in JAM, and also I have discussed the syllabus of MS JAM examination. So please watch those videos also to get more information about Mathematical Statistics JAM exam, right? So in this video, I'll cover some more things related to JAM examination. Yeah, so let's get started. A lot of students asked me that whether we should take coachings or not. Right, so this is quite a subjective question. So each individual is different, right? So each person knows themselves better than others, right? So if you think that you can able to manage the topics, you are able to learn yourself, practice yourself, right? So you think that you are capable of managing all the topics, the syllabus that is there in the JAM examination, and there is no requirement of coaching, right? So go ahead without any coaching. But if you feel or have a slight doubt that you cannot learn yourself, or you want that someone to teach you properly each and every topic and make you practice, right? So go ahead with the coachings, right? Coachings are important if you feel that you are not able to manage yourself, right? So there is also a perception in some students that without coaching they cannot do it. This is not the case, right? Because I have seen students that that have cleared the JAM examination with coaching also and without coaching also. I myself, like in my preparation, I didn't take the coachings, right? I prepared without coaching, right? So this is a sort of decision making which you will face in each and every aspect of your life, right? So before making any decision, you have to analyze the advantage and disadvantages of taking that decision. So coaching, so just try to see that what you think, that what would be advantages, what would be the pros and cons of taking that decision. So according to me, the coaching, what does it provide? So firstly, the teacher there will teach according to the syllabus that is being there, right? So like studying yourself, you might deviate from the topic, right? But in coachings, there are teachers that are teaching for many years, and they know exactly what the syllabus is and what they will teach, right? So this is one advantage. The another advantage is that you will get lot of people, lot of students, lot of fellow colleagues from which you can discuss the questions, discuss your doubts related to your questions that you have, right? But if you don't take coaching, so there are very less chances that in your group you will find anyone doing JAM. So this is I would say, advantage, that you can get a lot of students, a lot of friends from coachings to discuss with, teachers to discuss, to solve your doubts, right? So this is again an advantage. So yeah, coachings, if you see, so that this depends on you. Right, so at the end it depends on you, so as discussed, whether to take coachings or not. So if you feel that you are able to manage all the topics independently, so go ahead. And if you think that you need someone to make you learn, you need someone to discuss, you need someone to solve your doubts, your questions, your queries, discussions are needed, so go ahead with coachings, right? So coming to another question that is being asked a lot, that when one should start the preparation of JAM examination, and how much time one should devote daily while preparation, right? So this question again is very ad hoc, right? So I have seen students who just studied for 2 months and got cleared, right? And students who prepared much longer, but they weren't able to make it, right? So again, it depends on student to student, right? So but I think that according to me, 1 year is a sufficient time for the preparation of this JAM examination, IIT JAM examination for mathematical statistics. For other subjects, I can't comment, but for mathematical statistics, I would say that 1 year is a sufficient time to devote for your preparation, right? And be consistent, right? So don't be something like in a week you are studying, but in another week you are just not doing anything. So be consistent and try to devote 2 to 3 hours daily study topics, try to solve problems and be consistent with your preparation. That would be more helpful rather than studying in a week and just ignoring the other week and doing in a similar way. Try to focus and try to be consistent. So this I would suggest. So now talking about some tips and suggestions that I would like to give for your preparation. So first comes is the syllabus. So though the syllabus is limited, but be specific with the syllabus. So the things that are mentioned in the syllabus, try to stick to them, right? So don't deviate from the topic. So don't go beyond those topics. Try to be specific with the topics that are mentioned. Study them thoroughly and try to practice the questions related to them. So if you are doing coaching, so there are very less chances because the teachers know the syllabus quite well. If they are making you do some extra topics, so that might be useful in those topics, right? So this is not the case. But when you are independently doing, referring books, doing the topics, so make sure that you do not spend a lot of time doing the questions of the topics that are not the part of the syllabus, because this sometimes happens, because in some of the books you might find you might do some things extra, right? So be specific with the questions, with the topics that are there related to the syllabus, right? So next comes are the previous year question papers. This is very important, right? Previous year question papers, try to do them at least 2 to 3 times. So just leave last 2 to 3 years papers for last time preparation so that you can check yourself. But you should try to solve all the last year question papers for JAM mathematical examination for each and every topic, right? So that you will be able to know the level of the paper. You would be able to familiarize with the topics and the understandings. So I personally did it thrice, right? So I personally did it thrice and I find it very useful. So please focus on the last year previous papers. So if you see from 2005 onwards, so for some initial years, there were some subjective questions as well. So there are such subjective questions that are quite hard. So don't go into them, but there are also some MCQs and some subjective questions that are easy and manageable. So try to solve them. And if you think that you can solve the subject hard ones also, so you can try it once. So that would anyway help you, right? So try to focus on those questions as well, right? Previous year question papers, because you will be able to know the pattern, the questions, what's the level of the questions over there, and analyze also. So this is one thing that is with the previous year question papers. And when you are at the end of your preparation, right, you are done with all the topics, so to check yourself, so the 2-3 papers which you have not touched, so try them, right? Check your speed, that are you able to finish the papers in 3 hours or not. Check your speed, check your mistakes. So try to improve those mistakes in your 2 or 3 attempts that you have taken this paper. So do not get demotivated if you are not able to get through it, right? So these are like, learn from those mistakes and be prepared for the final showdown, right? So this is with the previous year question paper. So please pay heed to it and consider them really very important. So next comes, so there is also a mock examination that you are given on the site. So you'll get a link from IIT JAM Organizing Institute. So you can test yourself or check yourself on just a mock exam. So it just make you familiar with the actual surrounding that you will face in the actual date for the examination, right? So there is a calculator. There is an online calculator that you have to use. So get familiarize yourself with it, right? Because at that point of time, you might need calculator, but you are not able to find it. You might get panic, right? So please don't do these things. So try to familiarize yourself with the surroundings, the type of screen that you will have, where the questions will appear, where the things, calculator will be there, where the other things will be there. So try to familiarize yourself with each and everything, the actual setting will be, right? So one more thing is choosing the questions wisely, right? So there are not all questions that are meant to be solved, right? So there are some tough questions that you might struggle with, right? So you can leave them. So you have to choose your questions wisely, that you might feel that you are capable of doing that, and you will end up solving them correctly. So there might be some long questions, right? But that, so you might be scared, right? These are too long, I would not be able to do them. But actually they are easy to solve. And the short questions, if you see, they are very small to read, but actually they are very hard, right? So try to choose your questions wisely. And if you are stuck in any of the questions, so don't spend too long and don't get panicked. Leave the question and move ahead, right? So be cool and calm. Try to solve in a cool and calm manner. If you're not able to solve anything, don't spend too much time on that question. Try to solve that once, twice. If you're not able to, just move ahead and try with other questions, right? So as I discussed in my last video also, each and every topic is very important. So don't leave any of the topic. Right. So if you're not able to understand any topic or have doubts in understanding some of the topics, so try to at least familiarize yourself with the formulas that are there in that topic. So in any case, if easy questions come from that topic, so you're able to apply the formula and solve them if those questions are that way, right? So if there are any hard questions, so no problem. But if there are some easy questions, straightforward, that comes from the topic, right? From based on the formulas only. So at least you are able to solve them. So if not able to understand the topic deeply, so no problem. But don't leave it totally. Try to learn, try to focus as much as you can with your greatest capability, right? And one more suggestion that is quite important also I would like to give is solve your doubts. So if in any question you have doubt, so try to solve it. Because if that doubt remains the doubt, there will be no learning. You would not be able to solve the similar questions if it comes in the examination, right? So there will be no learning. So try to solve your doubts with the help of your teachers, with friends, discuss with your friends in the college or in the coachings you have, right? So solve your doubts. So in the JAM examination, the previous year papers, if you see this, there is no solution that is available. Like in our time, it wasn't available. In today, I don't know if it has been there, but the solutions for the papers are not there. So you need a lot of help from teachers, from your students to discuss about those questions, right? So solve your doubts and practice thoroughly. I have discussed the pattern of the paper earlier also. So it has three sections: MCQs, MSQs and NAT, right? So MSQs, multiple select questions, so they are MCQs only, but they have more than one correct answer, more than one correct answer for each of the questions. So there can be one or more than one. So these are bit tough, right? So you can attempt it at the last, because there are more than one answer, so you might be able to get one or two, but you might not know, right, that is the only one, or there are more correct answers to that question, right? So these are a bit tough. And for the MCQs, there is a negative marking also, so please just don't randomly guess any of the questions. So try to answer that, and if you are not able to make it, so just leave it. So don't unnecessarily answer that unless or until you have some sort of confidence on it, right? And NATs, there's a numerical answer type questions, that have the numerical answers to it, right? Integers, numerical integers, positive integers answers to it. So that is also that don't have options to it, right? So there is no negative marking for MSQs and NAT, but there is a negative marking for MCQs. So the way I did was, firstly I attempted MCQs, then Then I went to NAT numerical answer type, and then MSQ. So some of the MSQs are also easy. So at least you can go through it. So in the end, the time is less. So you can just see that which of the MSQs you find to be solvable for you, right? So you can find that, and then you can solve accordingly. So try to focus on MCQs as much as you can get them correct, right? Because 50 marks of the paper, the 50%, I would say 50 marks, so that attributes the MCQs only. So 10 MCQs for 1 mark and 20 MCQs for 2 marks, right? So these are the MCQs, and MSQs are for again 20 marks, 10 questions of 2 marks each, and numerical answer type questions are again for 30 marks, 1 mark each, 10 questions, 2 mark each, 10 questions again, right? So this is something that also depends on person to person and quite ad hoc. This depends on the exact situation. The last day preparation. So don't get panic, or don't study too much the day before the examination. Try to calm yourself, revise the formulas only. Like you might be having the notes that you have prepared, right? So revise them, go through them. Just don't study the whole day. Like just revise it for 2-3 hours. Keep yourself cool, calm the day before the examination. Reach your center timely, and make yourself comfortable over there, and give your best shot. All the very best, right? So hope you have liked the video, the suggestions, and the various questions that students usually ask, right? So please like the video, please subscribe to my channel, click on the bell icon for the notifications. Keep shining. Thank you.